Good morning, students. I hope you are all fine at home. In previous class, we finished our third chapters. Now, we are going to see about exercise 2.1 as a revision for your September monthly test. Okay, we are going to see the exercise 2.1 first sum. Okay, this is related to partial fraction. The question is 3x plus 7 divided by x square minus 3x plus 2. Equal to 3x by plus 7 divided by, we are splitting this x square minus 3x plus 2 as two factors. One is x minus 2, another one is x minus 1. Therefore, it is equal to a by x minus 2 plus b by x minus 1. Okay. So, after dividing it into two factors, we taking LCM or you may multiply by these factors both the sides. Okay. After multiplication of this factor x minus 2 into x minus 1 by both that side, that is left hand side as well as right hand side, we are getting 3x plus 7 equal to a into x minus 1 minus b into x minus 2. Now, in a into x minus 1, the factor is minus 1. So, put plus 1 in order to eliminate the term a. Okay. So, putting x equal to 1 in 1, we are getting 3 plus 7, that is 3 into 1, 3 plus 7 equal to a equal to a becomes 0, a becomes 0 because a into 1 minus 1 it becomes 0 plus b into 1 minus 2, b equal to 10. So likewise, put x equal to 2 in order to get the values, of this second equation, get the values of b. Okay, so put the value b equal to 2. Okay, so after substituting b equal to 2, we get 6 plus 7 equal to a into 2 minus 1 minus 0. We are getting the value of b equal to 10 and a equal to 13. So now substitute these values, a equal to 13 and b equal to 10 in a by x minus 2 plus b by x minus 2, that is a is 13 by x minus 2 plus b equal to minus 10 by x minus 1. Okay, so this is the answer for your first topic. Okay, next we are going to see about 4x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 into x plus 1. So here also it is already this in factor form, that is two factors are the x minus 2 and x plus 1. Therefore, we may write it as 4x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 into x plus 1 equal to a by x minus 2 plus b by x plus 1. Okay. After dividing into two factors, we multiply by these factors both the side. That is x minus 2 into x plus 1 is multiplied both the sides. Here left hand side x minus 2 and x plus 1 is cancelled. We are getting 4x plus 1. And right hand side a into x minus 1 plus b into x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 x plus 1. Okay, so here becomes a into x plus 1 plus b into x minus 2. Put x equal to minus 1 in order to eliminate the factor a, that is in order to eliminate the term a. So we are getting 3 equal to minus 3b, whereas b equal to 1. Now b into x minus 2 is there, therefore put x equal to 2 in order to eliminate b equal to 0. Put x equal to 2 in 1, we get a plus 1 equal to a by 2 plus 1 plus 0 equal to 9, that is 3a equal to 9, a equal to 3. Okay, now substitute this value, that is a equal to 3 means 3 by x minus 2, 4x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 x plus 1. After splitting into 2 partial fraction, we are getting 3 by x minus 2 plus 1 by x plus 1. Okay, so likewise you do the remaining sum also in this exercise. Now we are going to see the second exercise in second chapter. Evaluate n factorial into r factorial into n minus r factorial, where n equal to 5 and r equal to 2. Okay, so when n equal to 5 and r equal to 2 means substitute these values in this factor given, that is n factorial means it is 5 factorial, r factorial becomes 2 factorial, n minus r factorial become 5 minus 2 factorial. Okay, what is the value of 5 factorial? 5 factorial is nothing but 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 2 factorial is nothing but 1 into 2, and 5 minus 2 becomes 3 factorial, therefore it becomes 3 into 2 into 1. After cancelling, we are getting 5 into 2 equal to 10. That is the answer for this question. So this type of questions are asked in 2 marks as well as in 3 marks depending upon the question papers. Okay, now we are going to see the third sum. If n plus 1 factorial equal to 60 into n minus 1, find n. Okay, here it is given that n plus 2 factorial equal to 60, n 60 into n minus 1 factorial, find n. Now, which is the lowest term here? N minus 1. So, we are changing the n plus 2 in terms of n minus 1 factorial. That is, for example, 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3. Likewise, we are writing here also n plus 2 factorial is becomes n plus 2 into n plus 1 into n into n minus 1. So, for each and every term, we are reducing 1. Okay? So, n plus 2 minus 1 become n plus 1. Minus 1, n plus 1 minus 1, we are getting n. N minus 1, we are getting n minus 1. So, both the sides, 60 equal to 60 into n minus 1. Both the sides, n minus 1 factorial is there. Therefore, it is cancelled. Okay? So, we are getting n plus 2, n minus 1 into n equal to 60. So, now factorize this 60 in order to get 3 terms like this. That is 5 into 4 into 3. That is a continuous terms it becomes. Then 5 minus 1 become 4. 4 minus 1 becomes 3. Therefore, n equal to 3. That is a, here the smallest value is n. N is 3 means n plus 1 is 4. N plus 2 equal to 5. Therefore, n equal to 3. So, this is the way we are finding the value of n. If n plus 2 factorial and n minus 1 factorial is given means. Okay. Next, we are going to see the next model sums. Okay. Next model is, how many 5 digit telephone numbers can be constructed using the digit 0 to 9 if each number start with 67 with no digit appears more than once? Here, it is said that 67, already it is that there are the number of digit is totally 5. It is 5 digit telephone number. Already first 2 digits are given, that is 6 and 7 is given. We are writing only the 1's place, 10's place and 100 place. Because 1000 place and 10,000 place is 6 and 7. Okay. So, for 5 digit number, the number starts with 67. So, we have to fill the unit place, 10's place and 100 place. So, unit place can be filled in 8 ways because there are 0 to 9 means it is 10 numbers. From these 10 numbers, already 6 and 7 is there because there is no repetition. Remaining number is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9. Okay, totally we are having 8 numbers. Therefore, unit place can be filled in 8 ways using the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 and 9. Okay, after this, 10's place can be filled in 7 ways because from this 8 number, I filled the unit place by 1 number. Any number, it may be, but I am using 1 number. So, if I used 1 numbers, mean remaining how many numbers are the 7 numbers. Therefore, 10's place can be filled in 7 ways since the repetition is not allowed. Okay. Now going to the 100 place. So, already I used unit place 1 number, 10 place 1 number, total 8 numbers are there. From these 8 numbers, I used 2 numbers. Remaining number is 6. Therefore, 100 place can be filled up in 6 ways. Okay. After that, by fundamental principles of multiplication, the total number of 5 digits telephone numbers is, first 6 is 1 number, 7 is 1 number, and a unit place can be filled in 8 ways. 10's place can be filled in 7 ways. 100 place can be filled in 6 ways. So, after multiplying these things, we are getting 336 ways can be filled these numbers. Okay, so this is the way you have to find if telephone numbers cannot be repeated. That is, you can use some numbers and it cannot be repeated, means you may use like this. Okay, now we are going to see the next one. How many numbers lesser than 1000 can be formed using the digit 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 if no digit is repeated? Here, there are pi numbers are there. One is pi, 6, 7, 8, 9, pi numbers. How many numbers lesser than 1000 can be formed using this digit? Okay. Here we are doing the sum in three cases. First is less than 1000 means it includes one digit number, two digit number, as well as three digit number. Okay. Now I am going to see the first case with the three digit number. So any number less than 1000 will have three digit, two digit, as well as one digit. Therefore, unit place can be filled up in five ways because we are having five numbers. Okay. If it is three digit number means it is having unit place, tens place and hundred place. Okay. So unit place can be filled by using these five numbers. Therefore, it is five ways. After taking one number for unit place, we are having remaining four numbers. So by using these four numbers, I am filling the tens place. Okay. So tens place can be filled in four ways since the repetition is not allowed. Okay. Then after taking one number for unit place and tens place, one number for tenth place, we are having only three numbers. So I am filling the hundred place can be filled up in three ways. So this is for three digit number. Listen, this is for three digit number. If the number less than 1000 may be having one digit number, two digit number and three digit number. So first I am finding only the three digit number less than 1000 by using this number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So by fundamental principles of multiplication, the total number less than 1000 for case 2 is with the two digit number. So first I finished the case 1. Okay, now I am going to see about the case 2. After finding these three cases, we are finding the answer by way of adding all those things. Okay, so 5 4s are 20, 23s are 60. Okay, so if you get three digit number is, it is 60 ways. 5 into 4 into 3, first case I am saying 5 into 4 into 3, we are getting 60 ways. Okay, now we are going to see the second case. Okay, case with the two digit numbers. Okay, two digit numbers means we are having two places. One is unit place, another one is tens place. Okay, we are having again there are five numbers are there. Okay, for unit place also we are using that five numbers. So the unit place can be filled up in five ways because we are having five numbers. Then after taking one number for unit place, we are having only four numbers. So I'm using these four number, I fill the tens place in four ways. So 5 into 4, 5 fours are 20. Okay. So case 2, that is unit, that is if it is a two digit number is, we may having 20 ways. Okay. So for 1000, for three digit number it is 60 ways, for two digit number it is 20 ways. Now coming to the third case with this one digit number. One digit number means 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. I am using only this number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it is 5 ways. Obviously it is 5 ways because 5 numbers are there. So from 1, 2 and 3, the total number of numbers less than 1000 will be 60 plus, that is 3 digit number plus 2 digit number plus 1 digit number, that is 60 plus 20 plus 5. We are getting 85. Okay. So this is the way you have to finish because it may be asked in 5 marks also sometimes, but mostly it is asked in 3 marks. Okay. Okay. Prepare well for your September monthly test. Revise it well. Okay. Don't omit anything. So if you revise all this, that is the PDF form I am giving this, nearly 9 pages are there. So if you prepare this PDF well, it is easy for you to score full marks in your September monthly test. Okay. Now we are going to see the next sum. Verify 8c4 plus 8c3 equal to 9c4. Okay. So verify 8c4 plus 8c3 equal to 9c4. Here LHS equal to 8c4 plus 8c3. Okay. So what is mean by 8c4? NCR formula. Using NCR formula, N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Okay. So what is the value of N factorial here? 8. So 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 4 factorial plus 8C3 is nothing but 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 3 factorial, that is R is 3 here. Then 8 minus 3, it is 5. Okay. So n minus r means 8 minus 3, we are getting 5 factorial. That is 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 4 factorial plus 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 5 factorial. So in both the cases 8 factorial is common. So I am taking 8 factorial as common as outside. So we are getting 8 factorial into 1 by 4 factorial into 4 into 3 factorial, because in next term 3 factorials are there. Therefore I am changing the 4 factorial in terms of 3 factorial by way of 4 into 3 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial into 5 into 4 factorial. So here 5 factorial is reduced in terms of 4 factorial, because I am taking 3 factorial and 4 factorial as common. So I am changing in terms of 4 factorial and 3 factorial in both the side. Now take the 4 factorial and 3 factorial as common. So we are getting 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 3 factorial into 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. Okay. Now taking LCM for this 4 and 5, we are getting 20 as LCM. So 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 3 factorial into 5 plus 4 by 20, that is 9 by 20. So 8 factorial into 9 means nothing but 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 20. So after cancelling it, you are getting 126. Okay, you may cancel as in your way. Okay, so for cancelling, you may follow anyway. So 9 factorial means 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6 into 7 into 8 into 9. Okay, 4 factorial means 1 into 3 into 4. Okay, 3 factorial means 1 into 2 into 3. Likewise, you may write all those things, afterwards you may cancel it. But 20 is not a factorial, it is a number. Okay, if factorial is given, then only you write 1 into 2 into 3. Factorial is means it is a symbol is there. So you, if that symbol is given, then only you are using that. Okay, so we are getting 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This is nothing but 9C4. Okay. So RHS is proved. Okay. So this is the way you are doing the 8C3 and 8C4 is given. Now we are going to see how many chords can be drawn through 21 points on a circle. A chord is obtained by joining any two points. For example, so if you are drawing a chord or diameter, whatever it may be, we need two points. Okay, here it is, they said as chord. Chord means it is the line which is drawn in the circle other than the diameter. Okay, so remaining all those things are considered as a chord. So if I drawing a chord by joining two points, okay, on a circle, means total number of chords drawn through 21 points is the same number of ways selecting two points. That is, from 21 points, I am selecting only two points in order to draw a chord. Therefore, 21C2, we may take it as a 21C2. 21C2 is nothing but 21 divided by 2 factorial. Here R is 2, okay, 2 factorial into 21 minus 2, we are getting 19 factorial. So here I am using NCR equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial, okay. So 21 into 20 into 19 factorial divided by 19 factorial is there. So 19 cancelled. Then 2 and 10, 20s are cancelled. We are getting 21 into 10, 210, okay, as the answer. So, how many ways triangles can be formed by joining the vertices of a hexagon? So, these sums are, I finished already. It is a revision, so revise it well, concentrate it well. There are 6 vertices of a hexagon, you know well. So, one triangle needed 3 vertices. So, in hexagon, there are 6 vertices. We needed 3 vertices in order to draw a triangle. So, 6C3, that is from 6 points, I am using 3 points in order to draw a triangle. So, 6C3 means 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 6 minus 3, that is 3 factorial. After cancelling, we are getting 20, okay, as the answer for it. Okay. So, students, prepare well for your September monthly exam. Afternoon we revise the remaining sums in second chapters. So if you revise it well, then it is easy for you to score full marks also. So revise it well, don't waste your time. Okay, so then only it is easy for you to score more marks. Practice well, don't waste your time, practice well in order to score more marks. Thank you, students.